In this video, Sea Vision Productions takes you back to 1997 to view the final days of operations over Tennessee Pass. Videographer Dan Hadley takes us on a journey through the beautiful state of Colorado from Pueblo to Minturn, capturing a great variety of trains and locomotives along the way. Although the end was near, the railroad put on a fantastic show during the summer of 1997, giving fans one last chance to experience Tennessee Pass in all its glory. Beginning west of Pueblo, we'll follow the line westward towards Tennessee Pass and Minturn. Shortly after departing Pueblo, a westbound BNSF local makes its way along the Tennessee Pass line late in the evening. Setting up in Canyon City, we await the arrival of a Harrington, Kansas to Roper Yard freight with a Rio Grande tunnel motor on the point. Looking down into the spectacular Royal Gorge, two Union Pacific SD90 Max lead a westbound train of autoracks along the Arkansas River. Trains can still be seen passing through the Royal Gorge today, as both Rock and Rail and the Royal Gorge Route Railroad operate trains as far west as Parkdale. Rock and Rail will also occasionally venture west of Parkdale with trains of storage cars. Thank you. This train has just exited the Royal Gorge and is now bathed in beautiful golden light as it arrives in Parkdale. SP 9772 West departs the siding at Parkdale with train AHNOA. The symbol indicates that the train originated in Harrington, Kansas, and is bound for Oakland, California. For those interested, the train was routed through the siding to avoid a track defect on the main. Although the lead two units have been repainted into SP colors, all four of these locomotives are Rio Grande tunnel motors. The head two units still retain their Rio Grande identity, as both sport small DRGW sublettering below the road numbers on the cab. We spot a cautious lizard above Cotopaxi as we await the arrival of an eastbound coal train. Down at ground level, we catch a meet at the west end of Cotopaxi. A loaded taconite train works its way west, powered by six SPGEs. This train originated in Minnesota and is bound for Geneva Steel in Utah. Union Pacific made good use of distributed power on these trains, as two sets of DPUs were utilized to keep the trains moving and in one piece. High above Salida, the empty coal train seen earlier eases into the siding for a meet. The sounds of a parade also fill the air as the train enters town. An eastbound coal train overtakes a group of rafters as they head downriver at Hecla Junction. In the other direction, a westbound rack train passes Hecla Junction. East of Americus at milepost 243, train MEUCH passes Elephant Rock as it drifts downgrade into Buena Vista. Thank you. With dynamic brakes in use, a UPC30-7 leads train MROCH through the small community of Granite. MROCH originated at Roper Yard in Salt Lake City and was destined for Chicago. Another meet is seen, this time between a westbound empty coal train and eastbound auto train AROKS. In Malta, we take a close look at a classic Rio Grande boxcar as we await the arrival of a Roper Yard to Kansas City manifest. According to online sources, this boxcar still exists in 2023, stored east of Pueblo, Colorado. An eastbound Roper Yard to East St. Louis train has just conquered the steep climb from Minturn as it exits the east portal of Tennessee Pass Tunnel. Rio Grande 5407 leads this westbound out of the Tennessee Pass Tunnel and will now drop downgrade to Minturn. The grade here is very evident, as trained AROKS makes excellent time to the top of Tennessee Pass. This Salt Lake City to Kansas City train has plenty of power and very little tonnage, allowing it to operate up the pass at track speed. A Rio Grande SD50, now wearing Southern Pacific colors, leads this eastbound freight into Mitchell. Another eastbound works up the 3% grade of Tennessee Pass as it approaches Mitchell. With the elevation here nearing 10,000 feet, the trees have not yet fully leafed out. Quite the difference compared to the lower elevations south and east of here. Through freight service ended over Tennessee Pass on August 23, 1997. After that, very few moves were made over the pass before operations ended completely. According to reports, local service between Pueblo and Malta continued until March of 1999, with only a few work trains and storage train moves traversing the out-of-service portion of the line after that. Today, Union Pacific operates a local freight out of Grand Junction as far east as Gypsum. Storage moves east of Gypsum have occurred, but are not commonly seen. As mentioned earlier, trains regularly operate to Parkdale from the east, with occasional storage moves west of Parkdale. departing Minturn, train MROKS prepares to begin the battle for the summit of Tennessee Pass. We have arrived in Minturn, crew change point and helper base for Tennessee Pass. This eastbound coal train will cut in their helpers mid-train before heading up the pass. The trio of fine-looking Southern Pacific GEs will put on quite the show as they pull up to add their helpers.